710 KEEL. It's Robert J. Wright and Aaron McCarty, and in studio for a little bit is a fellow named Dr. Miles Hitchcock. Dr. Miles, we have not met before today. I was sort of aware of your background as a public servant, as a Shreveport guy, but for those of us listening who don't know much about you, tell us a little bit.
Thank you. I grew up in Shreveport. I was born in Shreveport. I was in the nursery with my now wife of 44 years at the old red brick Shumpert Hospital. Went to Queensboro, Lakeshore, and Fair Park High Schools and got a wonderful education. I went on and have graduate degrees in mathematics and information systems. And I have had a wonderful, rich, and full career.
Now, you also have a background in public service, in elected service. You were on the school board, I think?
I was an elected member of the Cattle Parish School Board for 8 years. That was some experience.
So, let me ask you, Miles, you got your blood boiling when we spoke with Administrative Commissioner Jay Dardenne Friday. And you were really... or wearing that whatever day it was, you said he is just not shooting straight with the people of Shreveport-Bossier. What bothered you most?
Remember now, we're talking now about Biomedical Research Foundation.
Yes, University Health.
And University Health.
And the disparity of funding between our local hospital and the one in New Orleans.
And more specifically, the governor's plan to some would say, attempt to boot BRF from that operating position.
Mm-hmm. There are two or three or 10 or 12 things that I don't like about what happened Friday. What happened with that? The first one is I'm not going to say Commissioner Dardenne was lying because I don't think he knew what he was enough about what he was talking about to lie. I believe that he and his boss, the governor, were caught. There were indisputable facts that came from documents that people had to sign a sworn statement on, and he could not refute them. He was not prepared to refute them. So what he did is he made a story up and created a smokescreen about, oh, you know that New Orleans deserves two times the money for treating half the number of indigent care patients because residents from LSU and New Orleans see people at other hospitals. What does that have to do with
that? That was what it bothered me about, because we have the numbers. We have 571 beds here. New Orleans' medical center has 253 beds. They get $410 million. We get $241 million. But when we talked to Jay about that disparity, he seemed to run like little spider web things, but essentially called those folks liars that were giving these numbers out.
When Representative Glover, who is the major flag waver for the explanation that BRF is somewhat behind in payments on a variety of things because they are underfunded by the state, Mr. Dardenne basically said, and talking about the numbers that Aaron just tossed out, that Representative Glover is either misinformed or purposely misleading. I would say you disagree with Commissioner Dardenne's statement.
I would be so bold as to say that Commissioner Dardenne was caught in a tough position. He had to defend something that was indefensible. So what do you do when you're in that category? You start making things up.
So those numbers... Mm.
I did those numbers.
Those numbers are correct.
Have in your possession a letter from me dated July the 25th to Governor Edwards. It's a three-page letter, and I laid those numbers out for him. I cited references in that letter, and I cited Medicare cost reports, which are the gold standard for truth in the healthcare mm-hmm. business, because an officer has to sign that under the condition of perjury. There's nothing to argue with.
Did we get to where they get so much more money? Is North Louisiana ignored? Do our lawmaker, are our lawmakers not effective? What's going on?
Aaron, you're not new in Louisiana any more than I am. You know what happens above and below I-10.
Mm-hmm.
What happens is that the federal government, through to the Department of Health, gives Louisiana, much like Senator Cassidy's talking about doing, a grant in a pot of money to take care of indigent patients through the Medicare system. Louisiana has to tell them how they're going to disperse that money. There is a 1,000-page document that describes how Louisiana distributes that money, and there are all kinds of funds in there that look like alphabet soup. Further, that 1,000-page document is supposed to be made public, and it is on the internet, but it is in a hidden location. They set that up where it is not searchable, where it can't be searched, but you have to know where it is to get to it because they don't want us to know.
Will you share that link so we can put it up and let people get to
yes.
it?
Yes.
Okay. Miles is kind of like Tiger, my dog. When I give him a chew toy,
yeah.
He is not letting go of it. You got actions you're planning if this dust doesn't settle, right?
Yes. I intend to see this through.
Okay.
So Aaron and I say this all the time, specifically about Representative Glover and Senator Tarver. And we say, how can two guys of seeming goodwill look at the same thing and see such different things, in this case, BRF? And on one hand, you have Representative Glover, whose stance is that BRF is in the financial position it's in. And as an effect of that, University Health is in the position it's in because we are grossly underfunded by politicians, as you put it, south of I-10. Senator Tarver's stance is, BRF just doesn't know what the hell they're doing. You tell me where you come down on that based on your research and your numbers that are in front of you right now.
I would tell you that they are both right in one sense. Tarver says that the medical school's underfunded, and Glover says that University Health is underfunded. Yes, both are true, sadly. Mm-hmm. The state of Louisiana cannot meet its financial obligations, period, and it's going to get worse, not better. And both of these institutions are being starved. Let me tell you what's going on.
Are they being, as some politicians have proffered, starved on purpose?
I do not believe that. With LSU, I believe with LSU, and the medical school, I honestly believe it's more benign neglect. It's my personal opinion that there is a very deliberate planned set of actions that are going on right now to do everything to include cutting off money and impacting patient care in this area to drive the current management of University Health out, because I think there is another agenda.
The agenda that we've heard is that Ochsner would be brought in to partner possibly with BRF to run the hospital. Is that an option that would be viable?
Yes, I certainly think it would be viable. I've done business with Ochsner for many years in the managed care business. I know them to be a reputable firm. They are well managed, etc. I frankly, with the track record of the state of Louisiana in this area, I cannot imagine anybody wanting to come into this. The state of Louisiana has a long history in this relationship of promising money through their assistant secretary in the Department of Health and Hospitals, putting out projections where a hospital makes a budget, goes ahead and starts spending that money to take care of patients, and then arbitrarily changes it. And I can't imagine anybody that would want a scenario like that.
What, Miles, what is the ultimate answer to this? New Orleans has got to give up some of their money. We got to find more money. What's the solution?
As I said in my letter to the governor, I'm not asking for more money. I'm asking for an equitable distribution of that money. And I am asking that there be some formula based upon the number of patients served. Our hospital up here serves roughly twice the number of Medicaid and indigent care patients as New Orleans. And New Orleans gets roughly twice the money for those patients.
And you think that's benign? You think, do you?
No. I said the LSU scenario was benign. The University Health scenario was very much planned and intended.
Do they want it closed? Do they want the local hospital closed?
No.
Surely not.
No, certainly not. Certainly not. I think though, that it's my opinion that the state is looking for someone that has lots of money, they perceive, to come in and present the pot of gold. The truth of it is, the system itself will provide lots of money. If we were up here, were just funded at the same level as New Orleans, and remember, we see twice the number of patients. Mm-hmm. If we were just seen at the same level as New Orleans, my letter to the governor says that would be $170 million a year coming into this hospital that we're not getting right now.
One more quick question. In your mind, is BRF doing the best they can with what they've got?
Oh, I think so. One of the things that you have in front of you is the total operating cost. Let me say again that LSU, that the New Orleans Hospital, which gets twice as much money, half as many patients, expends exactly the same amount that we spend up here for double that number. Mm. We're operating as efficiently as we can up here, but we're being starved to death.
Lastly, real quick, you're not giving up. You told us earlier off the air, what are you going to do? What's your plan if this is not solved? You're going to the feds, right?
Yes. Yes, I fully intend to. There are three very simple questions that I'm trying to get posed to the right people. If the answers to those questions will help determine, is the state of Louisiana doing what they told the federal government with these hundreds of millions of dollars? If they are, then I don't know what else I can do. But I don't believe they are. I think I know that they're not.
And then what?
Then I'm trying to get the legislative auditor involved and hoping that representatives from this area will ask them to get involved on the state level. And if not, I fully intend to file a complaint with the U.S. Department of Health. As you remember, that's Ben Carson's organization, with the U.S. Department of Health, alleging that Louisiana has published a plan that private citizens can't get to, that it's hidden somewhere on the internet, and it's at least my opinion that they are not living up to that.